radio streaming with free automation software radiodj and free audio streamer along with free radio stream hosting is what we'll be talking about today. You can use this setup for just about any audio music player or media player or even other radio automation software, but today I'll be using radiodj. In this video, you'll see how and where to get free audio stream hosting and all the software needed to run your own online streaming radio station. An important first note that the embedded audio streamer no longer works with radiodj. Altcast, which was originally compatible with radiodj, no longer works on the latest model. So we have a new way of doing it. If you want to use Altcast, you will have to install an older version of radiodj. If you'd like to see a video about using Altcast as a streamer, let me know in the comments. The first piece of software you will need is a virtual cable. There is a link in the description to get your free download. Choose the version for your computer, download it, extract it, and then click this file to install it. Click the big install button and you should see this pop up. Now go back to radiodj. Make sure you are logged in with admin as your name and password. Click the options button here and click the options button again here on this panel. Go to your sound devices and change your main output to the virtual cable you just installed. The reason for this is so you don't accidentally stream other sound from your computer to your streaming radio station. If you have a dedicated computer that only does the streaming, you can skip this part and leave the audio set to your speaker output. Put all your other outputs except your Q channel to go to the virtual cable as well, unless you're not using one. If you have a second sound card, you can also use that as your main output instead of the virtual cable. Now download a program called SEcaster. There is a link in the description to get your free download. Download it and extract it. Then go to the folder where you have extracted the files, and if you click on this file, it will start running SEcaster. Now go back to this file in the folder and make a shortcut to this file. You can put it on your desktop or in your radiodj folder, wherever is the most convenient for you. Check that the shortcut works, then close it. Now for your free radio streaming hosting, go to Caster FM. There is a link in the description to get to Caster's free radio streaming. On this sign-in page, click Create Account. You can put your full details here, and you must use an email address that you have access to, because a link will be sent in an email to confirm your new account, and if you lose your password, etc., you will need to be able to access this email address. Create a password and write it down somewhere safe. Without the password, you will not be able to access your free streaming account. Click Create Account and you should get this display. Check your emails for a reply from Caster FM. Also check your spam folder just in case. It should only take a few minutes to get the email. When you do get it, open it up and it should look like this, with a button to click to confirm your email address, which will also take you to the free hosting site. Now that you are here at Caster FM, fill in all the basic details. There is a fair amount of information you need to enter at this startup stage, so be patient and go through each step. Click Create Channel. You should see this pop up. Now, there are a few more steps before you can stream. Once it's all done, you won't need to fill in anything again. Click the dashboard tab up here. All your channel information is here to set up your radio stream. But unfortunately, none of it will work until you have finished filling in a few more details. Click here where it says website is not configured yet. Fill in all your radio station information under website configuration. You will see as you start that there is quite a list of information that is needed. If you want to run a professional radio station, then this information is important for your listeners, as well as make your streaming site have better SEO for Google and other search engines. So again, be patient and fill in all the information. If you are just running this as a test to check it out, then put in pretty much whatever information you want. Don't forget to add your radio station logo. Make sure you have enough text to turn the box from red to black. Click the submit button. There is one last bit of text you need to put in, so click the homepage tab and fill in a bit of text here. You can put all the good stuff here for your radio station, like photos and so on, or just fill in the space with a bit of text. This information will be displayed along with the previous page to listeners, so be careful what you type here and on the station information page, because this is public information. Click the submit button again and all warning messages should be gone. Now click the tab to go back to your dashboard. Now before you set up the stream in the audio streamer, make sure you have some music playing to be sure there is a signal. Just use some copyright-free or public domain music you can get from YouTube, because this music will immediately become listenable as your stream turns on. You just want something to play for an audio signal. Log in and check your audio device is configured correctly. Now start up your SEcaster streamer program and click on this button to check that the input signal is the same as the radiodj output device. If you don't have a virtual cable or have a dedicated computer for streaming, then set this input to the main audio output of your PC. Now click save. Start your music playing on radiodj or whichever audio player you are using. Make sure there is an audio signal showing on your SEcaster display. Now go back to your audio stream hosting and put the information into SEcaster. To do this, click the red plus button to add a stream. On this panel, you must select Icecast because you will need to put in the mount in here. Copy the server host name into the server here. Copy the server port number into the port number box. The broadcast name is your username, which is just source. Now use the broadcast password as your stream password. This is not your own password, but one given to you here by Caster FM. Now also, if you want your stream to be public on Icecast, you can tick this box, but your radio streaming will still work even if it's not publicly available on Icecast. Copy this mount point and put it in the mount section. Don't click auto start for now. You can change this to auto start later, but for now don't tick this box. Set your audio to AAC and your bitrate to 96 kilobits per second. This is the maximum bitrate for your free account. Don't worry, it sounds great in AAC. Lock the bitrate to make sure you don't exceed the limit of 96 and click save. Now you need to turn on your free streaming server by clicking the Start Server button. After a few seconds, your server will turn on and you will see this pop up. Just close this and you can see your streamer host server is online. But you are still off air, so bring up your SEcaster panel. Click this Edit button to check if your details are correct. Make sure you highlight the URL you want to broadcast to, especially if you have created different ones. Then click this Play button. You will see this notice, stream starts successfully. You can now see that you are in fact on air and your audio is live to the world. You can see the data being sent on your SEcaster and the bitrate and so on. You can also see that you have no listeners right now, so let's fix that. So go back to your dashboard and on this block called website, copy the website link of where your radio stream is. You can share this link with whoever you want. You can post it to your radio station website and share on your social media if you want. The link will bring you to this page where listeners can play your stream. Once you have set up all your show schedules, it will appear here. But for now, let's just listen to the music. You can now see that you have one live listener, and I opened another device so it shows a second listener that was on but not live now. What I really like about Caster FM is that you can see the listener stats, which is not available on many free streamer services. If you go to the listener tab on the top of the page, you can see more details like where in the world they are listening. If you want to get rid of listeners, you can select them and drop them here. I would not recommend this unless you have reached your maximum amount of listeners and you want people in a certain area to be able to listen. At a quick glance, you can also see your live streamers here. I stopped the stream and started it, so now you don't see the two listeners, but only the ones that are live since the stream started again. For more videos like this on radio streaming or radio DJ tutorials, click on a link here that you like and be sure to subscribe to be notified of new videos. See you in the next one.